Well, hello everyone. Today we're going to be looking at my latest creation. It's the Mechtrum, a mechanical ZX Mechtrum case. We will be looking at some of my design choices, how we got to this point, and also how you can buy one. So without further ado, let's go. If you've been watching my recent videos, you'll know that I bought this Mechtrum, which is in a very sad state, and also just a board that didn't have a case. And I was looking at my options on getting new cases and obviously repairing this one. So this one would need the new metal part, and it would also need a new membrane because not all the keys are working. And then I was looking around at finding a used case or one of the new cases, but then I would also need other parts that go with it. While I was searching around, I found this mechanical keyboard PCB by Don Superfo. And this was designed to work with the ZX Max 128, which is a modern 128 replica, but it's compatible with the 48K. And I decided to buy it. I did have a few of these blue switches, so I just ordered a few more. They're very cheap and they just fit in. After finding this, realizing that I had some of the mechanical keys, I knew that I wanted to design a case with a mechanical keyboard for the two Mechtrums that I have. So after a lot of testing and prototyping and designing and printing, this is what I've ended up with. So this is the Mechtrum. It's the mechanical ZX Mechtrum. And I absolutely love it. I couldn't be more happy with the way that it turned out. So we have the mechanical keyboard and these keycaps, who are from Maniferi. He designed the Engo and made the Engo case, and he had a mechanical keyboard for that. And I've had one of those in the past. So I ordered a set from him and he just tweaked it so that all the keys are the same size. Then on the back cover has got actual vents in there to allow some of the heat to get out. And then I had to put the rainbow stripe on the top just to break that up and add a bit of color. Here is the back, and you'll see that I've got an insertable IO shield. So if we're using a board like a Harlequin or something else that maybe has a VGA port or something different, that can just be changed. Or you could print a cover that goes all the way across the back if you wanted to. The bottom, we have got rubber feet on the corners. I left holes for the speaker. This grid pattern just breaks up the bottom so that we don't get ugly long printable lines as the print goes across. Thank you to Rich RepRap for that idea. And you'll see at the bottom there are more grills, so hopefully we'll get some convection, cold air pulled in and coming out the back. If we quickly look inside, you will see that this is just a normal Mechtrum board. This is an issue 3. And then the mechanical keyboard is wired in. I had some PCBs made by PCB Way, and this allows us to insert the keyboard into the place where the old membrane would go. So if we wanted to go back to a normal membrane keyboard, we just take those out, no damage done to the board. You will notice that there is no heatsink on this board, and that is purely to stop the hot heatsink damaging and warping the PLA plastic. PLA will start to deform around about 50 degrees, 60 degrees. I do recommend that you remove the heatsink and go with some form of switching regulator on there. Not only will it keep the case good, but it will also prolong the life of the Mechtrum. It's no longer sitting underneath that red hot baking heatsink, so these components will last longer. You'll also see that I've got some heatsinks on the ULA and the CPU. And that is our mechanical ZX Mechtrum, the Mechtrum. So now let's get down to business. I have 10 of these circuit boards. I have enough of these blue mechanical switches, and I have 10 sets of keycaps which are on order. And I should be getting those in, let's say, the beginning of January. I'm going to be listing these for pre-sale on my website, leesmithsworkshop.co.uk. Depending on how the 10 pre-sales go, I will leave it as an open, so not just 10. But bear in mind, once the first 10 have gone, then I will have to order more circuit boards and more key switches and keycaps. So there could be a delay on those, like another month or so, but that would be a very nice problem to have. So there will be a link in the description to the shop where you can order one of these. Because I have only got the one case, you could choose to have a different color if you wanted to and do like this black, This is a matte black by Everyone. You could have any of the Everyone colours. They do have a very big range, but the matte black does a good job of hiding lots of the print lines, and it does look nice. You get a nice finish on this part because it's printed face down on the textured bed, so it looks really, really nice. So 10 of these could be shipped early January, and then depending on how popular it is, we'll look at what the next batch could be. This is what you will receive in your order. You will have the bottom, the back, the keyboard fully assembled, so it will come with the cables and everything ready in place. These are just temporary screws while I'm waiting for the correct ones to come in. You'll have the back insert, and you will have a bag of screws. This isn't a final print, so there's a few bits on this that are different, but this is basically enough that I can show you anyway. So like I said, I really recommend that you have a board that has the heatsink removed and some form of switching regulator installed. So we just line it up with the mount holes in the bottom. There will be the very small screw which goes in the center. Remember, you are screwing into 3D printed parts, so don't over tighten anything. That's all we have to do on there. Then if you place the keyboard at the bottom of the case, we can plug in the connectors into where the membranes used to be. So they will only go in one way, and they'll only go on one side. Just like that, so that the cables face to the bottom of the circuit board. So we fold that up, and we just want to bend the cables in, and we put this in. So on the version that you will receive, I won't include the threaded insert, it will just screw into the plastic. But you can see that there is a lip that runs around the outside of the keyboard, and that just sits on to the edge of the case. So if it's not in the right place, it will move around, and then you can just feel it so it snaps into place. Then we can flip it over, and I'm just holding the case together. And we put one of our screws in, and these are pan head hex screws. Again, do not over tighten. And then you would do one more screw at the front, but I'm not going to do it on this one because it's got the threaded insert in there. So that is our keyboard fitted onto the base. Then we want to do the back. So we just put our insert on the back. And then as we're putting this top bit on, we just want to line that up so that the grooves fit in the back as well. And then that just closes down. So just like with the front, I'm just holding that in place while we put our screws in. And again, there would be another one just here at the back, but I didn't recess it on this one, so it won't go all the way in. And like I said before, it will have the rubber feet on the bottom. So that is it. That is our Mechtrum fully assembled, ready to go. Simple as that. So in the past, I designed an enclosure for the Engo, which is a Spectrum Next clone. And this was one of the pieces that I had. And the basic layout is the same. You can see that pretty much fits in. So I had that as my base. I took that basic design and refined it down and printed quickly in this grey material. We have the basic design, and that would just fit in. And as you can see, everything fits in and lines up. And we've got the holes on the back. Then we need something for the keyboard, and I just made that so that fits in that way. And we've got the holes in the bottom, so that the legs of the keys don't get stuck on anything. And it was just a matter of, like, that would just sit on the top like that. Very simple. There's no way, there's no like mounting on this at the minute, so there was nothing to hold it in. But that was how I started. That was the first design of the case. Then I wanted to hide the circuit board, so I designed this insert that would go on top of the circuit board, and that would hide most of the PCB, and the keycaps would just go in, and then whatever key tops I would go on would hide whatever's left. So after this, I started to work on the top and was trying to get an idea of how I wanted it to look. You can see on this one, this was printed that way down. You can see the texture on the bottom. That comes from the texture of my printer. So that was printed that way. But then I gradually changed the design, and we've got these legs on here for the screws to go in. And I wanted that nice texture to be the face of the case, so that the part that we see, I'd rather see this texture than the top lines that you see on a print. Obviously, this is a very quick print, so I knew that it needed to be printed that way. Printing that way needs supports. So in order for this to print, there is a lot of supports that goes like that. So when it's printed, those supports support this section that would be otherwise floating in air. So it is wasteful, but it's not too bad, and it prints pretty easily. And again, our printed circuit board for the keys go in, and then we have the insert that goes on top, which hides as much of the circuit board as we can, and it also gives a slightly different tone of black to differentiate it from the rest. But I wasn't happy with just the one design. I wanted to try others based around other models of Mechtrums. So this one, as you can see, has got the rounded edges, much like the Mechtrum case. So rather than having to support these because they're face down, we have to support everything because it's standing up. So this is the amount of support that was taken from inside of there, and I actually broke the case doing it. So it snapped across the top, and I had to glue it back on. It doesn't look particularly great because we see a lot of the lines from printing. This took 16 hours to print, and there's as much wasted material as there is here. This one takes 8 hours to print, and there's very little waste. So this is definitely the way that I wanted to go. The next style was more of a plus style case. So we have the grooves on the side that match up where the keys go. And then I could put these inserts in. So we've got the Mechtrum colors on the inserts. And also I left a little spot for a badge. You can buy some replica plus case badges. But again, I didn't like this one. I think just the plain case is better. So then I started to work on the base again, and I got the cutouts at the bottom for the larger soldered items that go into the bottom of the case. A Mechtrum board fits in just there. If you can see inside, the screw that holds the top of the case down also holds the motherboard in place. So we would have our PCB. We would have the cover to hide the PCB. And then I did a few different ideas for the back. So the first one was just plain. So it was quite bland. And then we can see on the back, we've got the IO ports. These little pegs here are going to be a problem because they're so small, they're going to break. So the next revision of this was this one. And you can see that I've got some vents in the bottom part, and I added the stripes on the corner. So now we're getting closer to our finished product. We could also have that one, but again, I just didn't like that one. It was a bit too scruffy. Or the rounded one. So my next revision, I printed in this rainbow filament. You can see that it changes color as it gets through this wall. But there's no control over the color changes. It is what it is on the spool. You can see here that it gradually merges between the colors. And if I wanted to have the darker color on the top every time, I would just have to waste whatever was before the darker color. So there was no real control. And also there was no way to control the colors so that you got a better blend going from the top to the bottom. The basic keyboard section was the same. On the top, we have the vents still at the bottom and the stripes. But what I changed on this one was the insert. So on the back, we now have a gap and we can change the insert to match whatever type of spectrum that we're using. So this was a basic test print just to test out some theories and make sure that they worked. And I just used up whatever was left on that spool. And luckily the test items all worked out as I wanted to. So from the multicolor print, we come to the next one. And I've been optimizing the printing. So we reduced the thickness of the base while still having some supports in there. We've got the cutout panel at the back. I've been stress testing the material. So you can see this one is breaking a little bit too easy. So I'm going to adjust the thickness to help with that. Then I did lots of testing on the keyboard inserts to get the spacing as small as possible to hide as much of the PCB. But at the same time, so that the keys fit in snugly. You can see that one's a little bit too big. Where that one fits in nicely. So when I'm soldering the keys onto the circuit board, this plastic part on top will actually help me keep the keys aligned so that they solder in straight. I also tweaked with the depth of the keys so that the keys were a little bit more recessed so that the key caps would be close to the top of this when they're pressed down. One more thing that I tried is I did a smooth top and I put some vinyl wrap on there to see what I thought about that. And this is okay, but it will eventually peel off and look a bit scruffy. But it was just a testing. You can see that I didn't even finish the print. We've still got lots of infill on show. There we go. That is 6 months work of designing and prototyping and testing. And we finally have the Mechtrum, the mechanical ZX Spectrum. I am very happy with it, and I hope anybody that buys it is also very happy with their purchase. It is pre-sale, and I hope to ship early in January. This will give you the option of choosing a case colour if you don't want black, and we can probably discuss case colours after you've made a purchase. I hope even if you're not interested in buying one that you found this interesting. I like making things. This is the exact sort of thing that I enjoy designing and making. So this was a very worthwhile, fulfilling project for me. Please like and subscribe if you want to help me in other ways. I do have a Patreon, so you could join the wonderful people who are scrolling across the bottom of the screen at the moment and help me to continue to make these amazing projects and all the things that I mess about with in my workshop. So I will see you on the next video. Bye!